it's all a lot of time. Try to go hit it fly. Everybody want a straight answer from me. And keep us mind up. It's hard. It's not hard to find my degree. We try to define infrastructure. Right on my time. Infrastructure. Right on my time. It's all to be talking. They're much about to protect themselves and others from political mislead.
So long, Rumi. I was on my fire. I can't hear it by what they say. They've been searching for that demon get denied. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Who? You talking about me? Man, whatever, man.
I'm gonna go. it is just the perfect time of year for a trip to the Carolinas, and that's where we find ourselves at Bank of America. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Buffalo Bills and the Carolina Panthers. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
And 10 at their own 22-yard line.
They're coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. Off play action. Jones. That's caught by the UCLA product. It's Caleb Wilson. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Now Jones. Here's Moss with a catch out of the backfield. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Throwing Jones. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Uchida Nwosu got the sack there.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. It's a 49-yard punt, but subtract 9 there for the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10.
33-yard line.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Brings up second and 2.
To throw, Kaepernick. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 23 yards the pickup there.
23 yards.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Kaepernick. He'll buy some time right. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. That'll bring up second down.
Well, that was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Kaepernick again here on second and 10. Man open left side is Brown. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 11 yards there, first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down to about the 21 or 22. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to love the way this has started.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run.
And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Damir Byrd, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bills have taken the early lead. Now, this is a crew. They've come out flat. They're losses, but just judging by the energy level, they look different here early, and that touchdown shows how.
Yeah, it seems to me that that touchdown gets them off the treadmill. Because, you know, you've been on the treadmill. I've seen you work out. You go forever and ever, and it tells you you've gone somewhere, but you're really out here in the same spot. They've exchanged it for an escalator. Still got some hills to climb, but they can get there.
These are good analogies. I run outside sometimes, though. You know, get some fresh air, a little sun on your face.
A little wind in there.
Yeah, that's right. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
Oh, you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went 3 and out.
And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. They'll try again from the 36 on 2nd and 10. To throw again. Jones looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. He will push his way down to about the 14. 2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play. 2 yards.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
On 2nd down, Freeman. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
On 3rd down, Devontae Freeman. And they'll get him down short of the 1st down, right on the 10-yard line. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll bring up 4th down.
A 4-yard gain. It's 4th down.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there, they'll go for it on 4th. Looking to throw. Jones. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And he's able to put it through.
That ties the game at 7.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
A solid run on 1st down, gain of 7, leaves them with a 2nd and 3. 7-7, our score after one.
The score tied 7-7.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Throwing now is Kaepernick. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Marquise Brown, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bills have taken the lead. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Back to throw, Jones. The hookup on the right side to Hopkins. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That's good for 28 yards.
The 47-yard line.
Looking to throw. Jones. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 22 more yards there and another first down.
That was a beautifully executed screen pass. Let the rushers get upfield. The blocking forms in front. Lofted it to the runner. And now, not only does he have open space in front of him, he's got an escort as well, and they pick up big yardage.
And oh, it's complete. What a catch at the 7. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. Three plays, three pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hitting this game, didn't it? For them to get downfield that quickly. And now first and goal, expect them to tap right here.
And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. Thaddeus Moss, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
The kick is good.
Extra point up and good by Sanders. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Caught left side, it's Beckham. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Second and two.
Working from the gun, it's Kaepernick, eluding the pressure right. And that's going to be incomplete.
No grounding call there. He had a receiver near the right sideline. It was pretty clear there. He just needed to get rid of that one.
And he did have a receiver in the area, but initially my view was obstructed, and I thought that was going to be grounding, but clearly the correct call made, and that is no call.
Is that why you threw your play sheet down? Is that why you did it? Is that the flag?
You can't be giving me up. I got a lot of issues up here in the booth. Kaepernick looking to throw, third and two. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown.
Touchdown, Buffalo.
Odell Beckham, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Bills have broken the tie.
So simple math here. The first half, they've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football.
We're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
23 yards, the final tally. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. There goes a deep ball, end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again, Jones. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 29-yard line. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory as they're down to the 29-yard line. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr. Thought he had the pick. Flag comes in for P.I., so cancel it out.
Interference. Oh, a killer for them. Thought they had a nice play. Instead, they'll be marching off yardage against them.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first, and he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21.
That ties the game at 21 apiece.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. Green to bring it back. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. D. Ford able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. He's going deep for Brown. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 37.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. At their own 37. Now a throw for the All-Pro Kelsey is complete. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards. So first and 10 now from the 30. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Letting one fly deep for Cooper. And this one is incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
But defensively, you're over there trying to catch your breath and try not to show the offense that you're a little bit fatigued. You're right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long field goal situation.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10.
52's the mic right here over there, right? 52's the mic. Hey, man, hey, man.
To throw again, Jones. They'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. They were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. That's going to be caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
At the 2 yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And they will take a 7-point lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
First and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's Kaepernick. Forced out to his left. Dumps it off to Gurley. Oh, he faked it with a juke. Now he's got some room. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown.
Todd Gurley.
His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. He's got it. This thing's turning a bit wild here. We're tied at 28.
28 all.
So right back to square one. Tied at 28 as he kicks it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Jones to throw again. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Amari Cooper as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers strike quickly here for 6 points.
These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it, lost it there. And it'll be second down. Trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, it's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And he returns this to the 22.
On the return, the Bills take over first and 10. At their own 22-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick, and they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. And that one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
Time. They spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
42-yard line.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
From the 39, Jones. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. David Onyemata able to record his 5th sack of the season. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Here's Jones throwing on 3rd and long. That's caught inside the 20. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills 19. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on 3rd and 15. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. That catch good for only a couple.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short gain.
Here
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. A solid pickup at 13 sets him up first and goal.
At the 4-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
And he takes it into the end zone for the Panthers' touchdown. A great effort there. His third touchdown of the game, number 11 on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And the kick is no good, but there are flags behind the line. He's going to get bailed out. I think this is going to be a roughing call. Sanders on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 14.
Makes the score Panthers 42, Bills 28.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Jordan Phillips able to take him down. It's a loss of 3.
Second down.
So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Play action. Now Kaepernick. He's going deep for Brown. And got his man complete. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their defense as well and get a few stops.
Here's a first down throw that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now throwing on first down and completing it. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
Odell Beckham Jr.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Looking left side, it's complete, he's got it. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
It's a gain of 6.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Kaepernick now on first down. That is caught at the 7. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. And passing yardage-wise, now up over 350 in this game. Pretty nice performance.
Definitely that, which usually means you're putting a lot of pressure on guys trying to cover. If you're a defensive back and they put over 350 yards on you, you've had a long day. The key to everything, if you're doing it without throwing interceptions or turning the ball over.
And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Todd Gurley standing by as lonesome in the backfield here. Second and goal. They'll get their receiver involved here. It's Brown. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. They'll try and push it in with Gurley. And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. Todd Gurley with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Bills draw a bit closer.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
To come out for the PAT, he can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line.
23-yard line.
Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. And despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing 3 there. Second down. The loss of 3 on that first down pass play. Now second and 13. Operating from the gun. Jones. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
The Panthers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. From the gun, Jones. And it's complete to Kelsey. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
The 40-yard line.
Jones now. Throwing on first down. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. This is caught at the 20. A big play there for the Panthers. And even 40 yards.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focus, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
It fights him off, but now he's swallowed up and taken down. Stephon Tuitt, able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
Gotta give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Now Jones, throwing on third and long. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked up by Sidney Jones. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. The interception sets them up with an opportunity to erase this fourth quarter deficit. Now this series could very well determine our outcome. They'll try and start the drive with Gurley. Room here to run.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one, 28 yards on the ground.
Well, they've certainly been successful throwing it around in this game. That's allowed them to move the ball on offense. But I've got to tell you, to watch them run the football and successfully, I'm not taking sides. But to see the ball in a running back's hands, oh, that's football for me.
Kaepernick now on first down. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And bringing it in right side here, Beckham. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 26. That one good for 26 and a first down. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll look to throw. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
And he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. Touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. Well, the hard part's done. Now they just need to split the posts, tie it up, but then their defense is going to have to hold up to send it to overtime.
Yeah, no matter what. I know there's an inclination in it when you have momentum to go for two here, but if you miss it, you don't give your defense a chance at all.
Plus, it's been a good game. I want to see overtime. I'm selfish.
You obviously don't have a flight to catch.
Tomorrow. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, it does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
38-yard line.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Operating from the gun, Jones. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Out of the gun, they give to Freeman. Tackled that time by Sidney Jones.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Brings up second and 7 at the 44-yard line.
Yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. From the 44, Jones will find Dobbins out of the backfield.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six. Heavy set out there on third and one. Throwing Jones. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. Now Jones, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 38, 30, past the 20, and he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. In a tie game, fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations type of plays they like to run, read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver, and it's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down.
Today's final score, Bills 49.
Well, Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that because when you have a lead in the fourth quarter, all you talk about doing is finishing and closing a game out. But when you flip it over, how about that? Making the comeback and then finishing the game, sealing it on defense, they will feel jubilant in their locker room.
So for Buffalo, it's a second win now as they move to 2-10 on the year. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, the playoffs look to be out of reach now as they drop to 4-8. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly to face off with the Eagles. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time. Pace with the swag, bet you can't do it like me. All my winners on repeat, take your L like a boss, standing toes on your